This segment is sponsored by the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
Join us in preserving and protecting Tennessee's wildlife.
All right, welcome back, everyone, to segment three. This time you can call us here at 615-737-7767 now, and they can ask any question they want to. Yeah. We'll be glad to answer what we know.
If we can, we'll
get you. If we don't know it, we will get you the answer. I promise
we'll get you.
Probably
have it by next week.
We might. We have got two great guests on here for a great cause. Justin was it on May the 2nd was involved in a
that's correct
a very bad accident. Was it anybody's fault? The rear axle was broken in two.
It was just a freak accident.
And we don't know what does all that and why this and why that. All we can do as fellow human beings is support those families that it happens to.
Yeah.
That's our job.
We can't dwell on the past.
No.
We just got to look into the future and just hope we can get him back in a boat because he loves fishing.
You know, I had a great pastor tell me that it's because your windshield's a lot bigger than your rearview mirror. It's for going forward instead of reminiscing about what's happened or going back.
So there is a grander plan.
There is a grander plan.
Absolutely.
You're exactly right, Brendan, and we don't necessarily know the answers. We're not smart enough. But all I know is, as a human being and a fellow fisherman and a fellow outdoorsman, and I love all of my buddies, and whether it be male or female that love to hunt and fish, we are supporting the same conservation.
Yeah, it's like a family.
It's a family.
We're all just a big
so
family.
So we've got a family member that's down, ladies and gentlemen, is what I'm trying to say. We've got a family member that's down. Let's support him. Saturday, Mark, get your calendars out. Get a notebook. Get a piece of paper. Get a card. Tell your wife.
Next Saturday, you got plans.
I got plans. And guess what? So do you. I want you to get raffle tickets. You bring home the raffle items, and I'm going to go try and catch that fish and win that $2,000, which is guaranteed first place.
Then you take her to dinner.
So,
and the raffle ticket, there's a lot of stuff for ladies. So, bring them on. And if you upset her because you went fishing, maybe you'll win something for a lady and you can bring it home and surprise her.
Does that really work? I'm just throwing it out there, but I have to put some realistic stuff in here. But instead of not asking them, why don't you ask them?
That's right.
And if you got a boat, why don't you make your wife your partner?
That works too.
You know, if it's for such a great cause, why don't we just go out there and have fun? We were going to donate it anyway.
Yep.
So let's just go have some fun.
Might as well get the fish.
We might get lucky.
That's right.
You know, and so you got to look at it that way. And I'm asking everybody, if you're watching the show or you're watching the repeats and the encores, please, let me tug on your heartstring just a little bit. This young man is supporting two kids. And if you have had two kids, I guarantee you know how tough that is. How would you like to do it from a wheelchair? How would you like to do it in another state? He's in another state right now and not able to take care of things. So if you were in that position, or if your family member was in that position, wouldn't you feel kind of responsible to kind of help out? I know I would. I know you would. I know you guys already would because you've done it already. But we just want to ask everybody, you know, why don't we come together for some things instead of being, well, I don't like bass fishing. Well, I don't like catfishing. Let's just all come together and go, we like fishing.
It's the fellowship after the tournament that's
right.
So much better.
Can I make a comment? You.
Yes, sir.
On the way over
that's
here.
That's enough.
On the way over here, I told Kevin, I said, I'm not looking at this as no competition tournament. This is a benefit tournament to help.
That's what we're
even
looking
though
at.
He's
That's
my
right.
son, it's one of our friends, it's a fellow fisherman. Justin, I always loved being around tournaments, and he just enjoyed the camaraderie.
Can I tell you what I'd like to see, Ricky? I don't think Cedar Creek can hold everybody that's going to come out there. That's what I'm saying.
We will make accommodations. We will make it happen.
If it won't, that's a good thing.
That's a great thing. That's the way, Ricky, you and I are going to stand on God's promise, and that's what's going to happen, okay? And that's what we're going to say, and we're going to call it such. And then let's make sure that everybody knows. I mean, it's $100.
$100 for the entry fee and $10 big fish, optional.
Optional, and you don't have to do it, but you know what? You're one throw away from winning. That's what I like to tell people.
Sir.
You're exactly one throw away from winning. So, and dude, I've seen some people win some stuff, and you know, here they are. And by the way, I don't know if everybody saw that, but Ranger came out with a boat that's almost $100,000 now. That's sticker price. So, but I've seen guys out there in $400 John boats win the tournament.
Yeah.
For big fish.
Yes, sir.
It don't make a bit of difference.
It doesn't matter. Nope. It doesn't matter. If you can throw it and you can stand in it or sit in it and throw out of it, you're legal.
That's
the way we want to see it. And just come on out there and have a good time with us. You got all kinds of, oh, we do it. Okay. We got all kinds of things going on. Raffles, catfish fries,
live auction.
Live auction, silent auction.
We're not doing a silent. It's going to be live. Mr. Gary Taylor himself, auctioneer.
Is he?
Oh, yes, sir. It's going to be a hoot. It's going to be a
mess. It will
be.
We've got...
let me say something about Gary. He came to Atlanta last week and visited Justin.
On his way to Gunnersville.
He was on his way to Gunnersville.
Did I not know? Did I tell you? Huh?
Huh?
Did I not know the boy?
He was.
And he's the one that'll go, you know, I took a wrong turn in Albuquerque.
That's him.
That's Gary.
That's Gary.
Oh, we like him. We love Gary, too. Mm-hmm. Hey, we got a caller. Let's go to Donnie. Donnie, how can we?
Johnny.
Johnny. Johnny, how can we help you tonight?
Hey, how you doing today, man?
We're doing great, Johnny.
I've been watching y'all show for a long time,
yes,
man.
Sir, you have.
What's all the fish on First and Priest, man? Me and my girlfriend have been going on every weekend. We get a few here, a few there, you know. Do I got to pay somebody to take me on there to fish?
Well, now, what are you wanting to fish for?
Anything to bite.
Well, now, I'm going to tell you, the nighttime bite at Percy Priest is on fire. They're doing really well. And not all of the fish are down deep. Mm-hmm. I've been noticing a lot of them are in the 8 to 10 foot to 12 foot range.
They're coming on up.
So the fishing's been good. Crappie has been scattered. But if you can find wood or trees on the banks of the river, underwater now, if you know what I'm talking about, where the first and second cut through is, if you find those trees, there is crappie in them. And I promise you, they are there by the jillions.
We've been catching them up on hickory, you know, 4 or 5 pounds, you know, largemouth, you know.
Yeah.
That's far me to go reach drive every weekend.
I know.
I live in Laverne.
Well, I tell you what, Laverne, you got Percy Priest right there, but come on now, Old Hickory's not that far away. But I will go where the fish are biting. And, you know, some, like Old Hickory struggled in the past. Now it's coming on a little bit. Percy Priest kind of hit a little low, but not much of one.
Mm-mm. No.
Because it's been on fire.
Priest
has been pretty hot this year.
Percy Priest has been one hot lake. Gunnersville, I'm going to tell you, I've got a good friend down there. Did I say that? Jeff Hill tells me, you got one day that's good, 2 days that's bad. One day is good, 2 days is bad.
That sounds like Old Hickory.
And it does. And you just got to be, Johnny, you got to be patient enough. And just, there is fish biting somewhere. But I'll tell you, the catfish ought to be tearing it up right now.
They are.
So.
On Priest?
I would say everywhere.
Yeah,
Old Hickory
also.
Old Hickory, am I right, Kevin? Some of the guys that went bass fishing just this last weekend on Old Hickory were catching some 20, 25-pound cats up shallow water.
2 weeks ago, up in shallow water, I was flipping a bullet.
15, 8-pound cats on blues on you.
Yeah.
Brent will dip in Kool-Aid.
Hey, don't give out everything. You're not supposed to say it, Johnny. Come on, man. I got that straight from Sid and Bubba's Pickard.
Bubba's been talking again.
Bubba's been talking again. I can tell we're going to have to get some duct tape for Bubba. But, Johnny,
Kool-Aid, man.
I'm telling you, man, I'm going to buy stock in Kool-Aid.
Yeah.
Because the way Bubba's been telling everybody, it's going to go up. But, Johnny, we appreciate appreciate it. But try them out. I promise you there's fish biting somewhere on these lakes.
Okay, thank you, sir. Have a good day.
You too, brother. And just a... whoops, I'm putting it on. Great having callers like that. But Bubba, we're after you. You're giving away the secrets there. Again, July 22nd, next Saturday, Safe Light. So what time is registration going to open?
I'm probably going to be there around 3 o'clock just to make sure that I'm there because I'm not, don't know how it's going to go. We're going to have people helping us with parking, helping you launch. In, out, whatever you need.
There's going to be. Checking live wells, everything.
We'll have, and if you're coming from across the water, we're going to have a man at the fuel pump, on the dock where the fuel pump is. He'll check your live wells, put your orange ribbon on, and so you're good to go.
Are we going to get a number or are we going to get a
You're going to have a number. Or? I'm going to have a card.
Okay. Just keep that with you.
Just like in some of the bigger tournaments we fish, you have mm-hmm. a card with your number on it, mm-hmm. and when you come, you'll get that when you sign up. And then when you come back in, the person will be at the fuel island again with the deal, and you got to hold your card up to show your number, and he'll check.
So they can check you
in. He can check that you're in.
Okay. And that's just a safety factor.
That is a safety factor.
We want to make sure everybody makes it out and comes back.
And we're going to do it in flights of 25, okay. 15 minutes apart, so we don't get everybody all there at one time when they're coming in.
Is it first come, first serve?
First come, first serve. First come, first serve. So. I don't have a ping pong ball with that many numbers to roll up. So.
Well, that's good, though. It sounds like it's going to be a neatly run tournament. So come on out there and try it. Hey, we got to do our tip of the week. And this week's tip is being brought to you by Davidson County Farmers Co-op. I'm going to tell you, Miss Laura and that crew step up, don't they? How do you like that new logo? Your hometown store. And it, we go there.
It is. Yeah, we spend a lot of time in and out.
Spend a lot of time over there. I like Miss Laura and all those fine folks she's got over there. They are eager to help you with all of your hometown needs. And Kevin, what's a great tip for us? Because we hated to put you on the spot, but we did it anyway.
You did. One of my biggest tips, I guess, I'm a mechanic from my background. June 1st and January 1st, I always check the water level of my batteries. I drain my lower unit, make sure it ain't got a seal leaking or something to cause damage further on. I just always set that date, and that's when I do it.
That's a great tip, because I don't think a lot of people do it two times a year.
If you check it and 3 months down the road, your seal starts leaking, you get a little water, you're fine, but you don't know it. You drain it, and there's a little, or you don't check it, and there's a little water in it, boom, there you go, big money.
Big money.
Just take it down to National Marine and David, and he'll fix you right up.
And well, you might even get David to do it.
You might.
Kevin, I appreciate you stepping up, buddy.
You know, that's another thing. All the marinas around here, with David with National Marine, Anderson Marine, Riverside Marine, it didn't matter.
Steve,
they all
Ray,
stepped up.
All
Steve, Ray.
Did you see that new speedboat Ray's got?
I seen something that natural. Ooh. What about the one David's got?
David's already headed out. He sent me a deal. He's already gone.
Yep.
He's leaving now for a big speedboat race.
Yeah.
And I'm just wondering if it's going to be David and Ray side by side.
I don't
mono
know.
Mono and mono.
So.
Great guys, though, that represent Nashville, and we appreciate them so very much. All right, we got to take a quick break. When we come back, Tom Courtney is in the house, and he's willing to give away a secret that keeps Brandon going in there every other day. Hurry back to more. So, what's it worth?